Now, this one is very interesting and helpful shortcut, and I tend to use it very regularly. What if you need to select an entire row or an entire column? Most of us, we normally go to the corner of that particular cell, and once you get this arrow down here, you just click it. And if you have to select the column, you go over here. Once the arrow appears, you click it to select the column. But there's an interesting shortcut for that, which is to use the shift and control along with spacebar. So if you have to select the entire row, the shortcut is shift and spacebar. And if you have to select the entire column, it's control and spacebar. Note that this shortcut is the same for both Mac and Windows versions. Believe me, it's a very, very useful shortcut and we tend to ignore it. Let's today look at a shortcut which most of us have either not used at all or have not even heard about it. But believe me, if you start using this shortcut, it will help you a lot. But before that, please make sure to subscribe to my channel and do hit the bell icon to get regular notifications for new videos. Now let's say you have got data like this. You have got 15 columns and 25 different rows and you have got data in each and every cell and you want to find certain data. So what will you do? You'll simply use the Control F or Command F to actually search data in this particular database. So once the find window opens up, you can just input the data that you want to find and then click find next, which will show you the match with your search query. And then if you click it again, it will go to the next match and so on. But what if you want to actually not have this window on your screen and just search for the next match? We have a shortcut for that as well. For all you Windows users, you might see that when the find window opens, you can see that there is a find all option as well. And when you click on that, you can go to each and every option individually. But still, this window will be there and you will not be able to see whatever is behind this window. You will have to kind of shift it up, shift it down to see the search items that are hidden behind this particular window. So let's find the shortcut today for finding the next match. In order to find the next match of your search query, the shortcut in Windows is Shift F4 and that in Mac is Command G. Now the most important thing for using this shortcut is that your search query should already be entered, which essentially means that let's say I use the same database again and I have to search for 37. So what I'll need to do is that first I'll do the normal search using Command F and then I'll enter 37. So it will go to first search for 37, then I close it. And now I use the shortcut, which is Command G in Mac and Shift F4 in Windows. So I just press it once, it'll go to the next one, it'll go to the next one and so on. So you can see how simple it is. And now if you need to change the search query, you will first need to use the search shortcut, which is Command F or Control F, enter the new number that you have. Let's say I have to search for 39. So I'll enter 39, just press enter or find next. It'll go to the first 39 in my table. I'll close it and then do a Command G, Command G, Command G, Command G. And every time I press Command G, it will go to the next match. Believe me, friends, this is a very important shortcut and very useful one. If you've got a lot of data, huge databases to search for. And the good thing about this shortcut is also that if your search query is a text, it will also search it in those cells where that text is present with a combination of other characters as well. So make sure to learn it because it'll help you a lot in all your search queries. There are times when you're supposed to enter the current date in a cell in the spreadsheet. Well, sometimes you might not remember the date at all and you just thought that I had a short key for this thing. So here's one. Just go to the particular cell where you want to enter the date. Press Control and colon together and then hit enter. There you go. You have the current date. Now, you might also need to enter the current time in your spreadsheet. And believe me, it's a bit difficult to enter it manually because it's to do with formats and other things. So what you do is that simply go to the cell where you want to enter the time. Press Control Shift and colon together and then hit Enter. There you go. You have the current time. And it's the simplest way to enter the time. Now, what if you're supposed to enter the current date and time? Well, it's simple. Press Control colon, space, Control Shift colon, and then enter. See, you get the date and time in the same cell.